You know, this is more of a statement, but I like the Representative Brinkman.
Representative, please try to couch it as a question. With your creative skills, I'm going to look at us.
Thank you, Chairman. I will be able to do that. You know, it's brought to my attention in doing away with or phasing out the collective bargaining initiative that there will be safety issues within the workplace. Has that been part of the idea of this whole bill?
Chairman Young, I work just like no, I have not made that be part of the idea of the bill. My understanding is that in many times this right to work makes the unions work harder for their membership, makes them earn their place. We'll have in the future testimony information from Indiana where union spending is up for their membership, that their numbers remain strong in that state, and that this has just had to make them be more competitive and get their workers and their membership to buy in. You know, what's always amazing to me is when I hear about when they have union elections, they actually have less of a turnout than we have in some of our anemic general elections. And you really wonder how much are people really involved in their unions. And I think this will make the unions be working harder for them. And creating, we come back to your question, working harder on safety concerns and collective bargaining and things like that. I happen to have a family member who works at a major union factory, and all he tells me is they sit around griping about the, you know, we'll file a grievance, but the union won't do anything about it. Well, nothing ever happens. Now, those are still, many of them are still union members because maybe they feel that's the only weird place they have to turn. But with right to work, perhaps the union would work harder for them and getting their grievances filed and be better aided. That's what I'm hoping would be another offshoot of this legislation.
So you think that, I mean, a union does represent the best interest of the worker or safety issue?
Chairman Young, well, they're supposed to, but whenever you have a captive shop, you can do a good job or you can do a bad job and you're still, the membership is still stuck with you. I'm thinking that if there's more competition and people aren't forced to join a union, they have to show more value and by working harder. And that's what I think this bill would force them to do, is work harder for their membership.
You know, I just believe that, you know, you need, if it weren't for the unions, it is going to stand for these people when there are unsafe work environments or unsafe, you know, anything. And, you know, it votes to be a rhetorical question because it's kind of a necessity.
Chairman Young, I think that there will still be advocates there. There's lots of companies that aren't union that still have to let people work in safe situations. We even dealt today on the floor with a workers' comp bill that had to deal with folks driving down the road and getting hit by other drivers, whether that would be an experience rate at the, for that company. That could have occurred to a union company or a non-union company. But the feeling is that still there would be some safety requirements because that non-union company would want their workers to be safe because they wouldn't want to have the expense of bills if they were just looking at the dollars if the employee was kept in an unsafe situation. So I guess I just don't see it as I guess social Darwinistic as maybe it was 100 years ago. And I think that people will, would negotiate in good faith and work out things like safety regulations together, whether